Hi everyone. You know that tiny lock icon next to your chat, the one that's supposed to mean you're safe? Yep, it's lying to you. Even when your AI chats are fully encrypted, researchers just proved they can guess what you're talking about without ever decrypting a single byte. No password stolen, no malware, no exploit, just by watching the rhythm of your conversation. The size and timing of those little packets leaving your device are enough to reveal your topic. So if you ask ChatGPT about your finances, your health, or maybe that job you are thinking of leaving, someone quietly watching your traffic could know. And here's the kicker. This isn't some internet rumor. It's Microsoft's own research published this week, and it affects almost every large language model online right now. They are calling it Whisper Leak. And over the next few minutes, I'll show you exactly how it works, what's been done about it, and the simple things you can do today to keep your conversation truly private. All right, let's pull up the receipt. This didn't come from a random hacker forum. It became straight from Microsoft's own security blog, published just a few days ago, November 7. And right before that, the full research paper dropped on ArcSive, the same platform where top universities post peer-reviewed studies. In it, Microsoft researchers show that they could take ordinary encrypted chat traffic, no access to messages, no stolen token, and still classify what topic you were discussing with scary precision. They tested multiple large language models, ChatGPT, Gemini, Claude, Mistral, and found that the vulnerability is not a bug in one company's code. It's baked into the way AI models stream tokens. Think about that for a second. The entire design of how AIs talk to us, token by token, might be exposing us more than the content ever could. And that's why this research matters. It's not just another tech story. It's a wake-up call for every single AI user who thought encryption was the end of the conversation. So, how can someone possibly read your chat without reading your chat? Here's the crazy part. They don't need to break the encryption at all. Every time your chatbot sends a word, it's actually sending a tiny burst of data, what researchers call a token stream. Each token has a specific size and a specific rhythm. Now, imagine someone standing outside your house, watching the blinking lights on your router. They can't hear the words, but they can tell when you're speaking fast, when you pause, when you stop. That pattern, the timing between each blink, becomes a fingerprint of what you're saying. That's exactly what happens here. The attacker doesn't see the message. They just watch the flow of encrypted packets, how big each one is, how fast they are sent, and train an AI model to recognize topics from those patterns. So when you ask your chatbot about credit cards or mental health, the packets form a rhythm the model has already learned to identify. It's not perfect, but it's accurate enough to spot what category your conversation falls into. No passwords, no backdoors, just pure metadata turned into insight. And this is why security experts are freaking out, because this flaw isn't in the software, it's in the physics of communication itself. All right, let's talk numbers, because this isn't a vague privacy scare. The results are quantifiable, and they're wild. In Microsoft's tests, the attack reached over 98% accuracy in identifying chat topics across multiple AI models. Even when researchers flooded the network with random noise, like 10,000 irrelevant chats for every real one, the classifier still hit 100% precision. Let that sink in. An algorithm watching encrypted packets could tell with near perfect confidence whether you were discussing money, health, politics, or code. And it's not just the model. They tested 28 different LLMs: OpenAI, Anthropic, Google, Mistral, and the leak pattern showed up almost everywhere. The researchers estimate that in live conditions, they could successfully flag between 5 and 20% of real-world chats. That's millions of conversations a day that could theoretically be profiled without ever touching the messages themselves. When encryption still leaks with 98% accuracy, you start to realize privacy isn't a switch you turn on. It's a spectrum we've barely begun to secure. So here's the question everyone asks next. Who can actually see this traffic? Well, it's not just some nation-state spy sitting in a bunker. In reality, almost anyone positioned between you and the AI could watch this pattern. Your internet service provider sees every conversation you make. The Wi-Fi admin at your office or your favorite cafe has visibility into the flow of packets. Inside companies, enterprise proxies and security gateways record traffic for compliance. Even a local attacker on public Wi-Fi can observe it if your connection is unshielded. None of these people can read your messages. Encryption still holds, but they can watch the behavior of the stream, how often you send, how big the bursts are, how long the pauses last. And that's enough to build a profile. Every time, they could infer what kind of work you do, when you are active, even which tools you rely on. So the threat isn't some Hollywood hacker breaking into your laptop. It's the invisible analytics happening quietly in the background from people and systems that you already trust. Good news is, the people building these models are not ignoring the problem. Right after Microsoft's disclosure, the big players, OpenAI, Microsoft, Mistral, and xAI, started rolling out mitigation layers. The first fix is padding and obfuscation, basically adding random noise to every packet so sizes don't match your actual words. The second one is batching, where tokens get bundled together before they are sent, breaking that one token equals one packet pattern. And a few teams are even experimenting with packet injection, sending harmless fake packets to blur the rhythm completely. These sound tiny, but they matter. Each layer makes the side channel attack harder, slower, and way less reliable. The catch? None of it's perfect. At least not yet. Some vendors only enable these defenses for enterprise tiers. Others make them optional because they add a little latency. So yes, the industry is moving fast, but unless these protections become on by default, privacy will still depend on whether your provider decides to flip that switch. Let's now bring this down to you. The biggest mistake most people make is assuming that encryption equals privacy. It does not. But the good news is you can actually lower your exposure starting today. First, if you're dealing with something sensitive, health, finances, work, avoid streaming mode. The attack only works when the model sends words token by token. Choose a full response mode instead. It's slower, but safer. Second, check whether your provider has implemented padding or batching. You will usually find that info in their API or security blog. If you can't find it, assume it's not there. Third, don't trust public or shared networks, cafes, airports, even your office guest Wi-Fi. Use a VPN if you have to, but remember, it's only a layer, not magic armor. And if you're part of a team or a company using AI tools, make sure your IT or compliance folks ask the right question. Is our provider protecting us at the metadata level, yes or no? Because when it comes to privacy, what you don't stream, what you don't expose, can make all the difference. Now I want to hear from you. Drop a quick comment below and tell me what's your setup. Are you using streaming on, streaming off, or honestly, are you not sure? I'll pin a vendor-by-vendor mitigation checklist right there in the comments so you can check where your favorite AI stands. And if this episode opened your eyes a little, hit that like button. It really helps more people see what's actually happening behind the scenes. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on the bell so you catch the next deep dive, because in the next system fracture episode, we are going to test several other different vulnerabilities or systems. And we will also see what vendors and people are talking about. Thanks for watching and for caring about security in a world that keeps getting more connected and more exposed. This is Max from Point Break Security, and you have been watching System Fracture, part of the Daily Signal channel. Stay sharp, stay curious, and I'll see you in the next one.